I'm going to show you how to turn this Guitar Pro MIDI into this finished song. Using only MIDI and samples. Also special thanks to Casey Carlson from the band Deadlands for providing her amazing vocals for this track. First, let's move our guitar MIDI into a track loaded with Odin 2. This will turn the MIDI into a guitar. Now we need to transpose this MIDI 12 semitones because Guitar Pro MIDI by default is not in the correct octave for Odin. Next, let's set the velocities anywhere between 125 and 100, ideally a bit on the higher side. Notice how those last few notes were choppy and odd? This is because Guitar Pro actually chops off every note that's a palmute. Generally, you want to connect all of your notes, so let's connect them and then set the velocity to 33, automatically triggering the palmutes inside Odin. Next, let's add an amp simulator to Odin so we don't just hear the DI sound. For this tutorial, we are using the brand new Runeforge Fenrir by Solemntones. Further into the song, we find some more of those choppy palmutes from Guitar Pro. So let's fix those in the same way we did before. In the next section, we have these abrupt mutes on the guitar and bass. Now this sounds awesome in that final production, but generally guitarists can't mute this quickly. There's usually going to be some type of sound, either from the left hand or the right hand, muting the string. The way we can emulate this is by copying the note that's being played right before, turning it extremely short, so short you can almost no longer see it in your piano roll, and then turning that into a palm mute. This will add a little bit of that percussive chuck right at the end, emulating that muting sound. Next, let's add those little mutes in a few more spots throughout the song and then quickly compare with the original to see if they were actually going for that abrupt, very robotic silence. The original made it very clear they were going for these robotic cutoffs, so we will keep them too. That should be most of the work for the guitar, so now let's move to bass. When it comes to metal bass, 95% of the time the bass is simply going to follow the guitar, so we will be doing the same thing here, only of course whenever the guitars play a chord, we will only be playing the root note on the bass. We're going to load the Sanguine bass by Solemntones and use the Core Studio preset, it's my favorite right now, and then we'll copy paste the MIDI from the guitar into that Sanguine bass track. I'll then color code it purple to keep things organized and then set all of the velocities to 127. I want this thing just slamming super consistently. As you could hear, those big chords sounded really cool on the guitar before, but here on bass it's just too much, so let's remove all of those chords throughout the whole MIDI. Next, let's see what that guitar and bass sounds like together with the drums. Of course, for the drums, we're using Mjolnir drums by Solemntones. During this quick playthrough, I noticed a little more of that choppiness. This time it was probably just me not having properly connected the notes, so let's fix that real quick. Now that we have a very basic guitar, bass, and drum mix, let's add in Casey's vocals. This is a pre-mixed vocal stem because this tutorial is not really trying to show you vocal mixing, but more so trying to show you the MIDI programming part of the production. Now, it wouldn't be an Ice Nine Kills song without some incredible production and effects and so forth, so let's add a synth soundscape to the chorus. After trying a few options, I ended up settling for this amazing saw-like synth inside Gravity by Heaviosity. The only issue with a massive pad like this is that it will take up all of the frequencies on the spectrum. So let's add a low cut filter to kind of get rid of most of it, because that's where our guitar low end and bass will live. We don't want that getting muddied up, we just want this to add a little flare without getting in the way. So it'll be pushed really, really far back, and later on you'll also notice I will be adding some more reverb to really wash it out. I also wanted to remove some of the high end because that's where the cymbals live. Next, we're adding a string melody to the chorus, and these are the notes. For the sound, I'm choosing Symphobia, but I personally don't recommend this library that much. I like it because it usually just quickly gets me a sound, but it's quite limited in what it can really do. And just like with the pads before, we're going to remove all of the low end to keep it nice and clean. It just has to be a little bit of a sound, adding some atmosphere without being very in the face, impactful, and potentially muddying things up. One thing I noticed is that the strings were very dry sounding and consistently poking through, so I end up adding some reverb with room. I then did the same to the pads because those were also poking through too much. Putting it all together again, I once again noticed that the strings were actually still a little too much, so I turned down the dry, and that way you get less of the original signal while still keeping your reverby washed out sound intact. Then I color coded those tracks for clarity. Now we move to the buzzy intro synth. Now I'm personally not a synth extraordinaire, so I just tried a couple presets, destroyed them with EQ, and then hoped that by the end of this I might find some other option. Speaking of effects, it was time to add all of the reverses, whooshes, riser, hits, and all of that good stuff. Of course, all of those sounds come from Bifrost 1 and Bifrost 2. All that happens here is that whenever there's a riser or a hit in the original, there's now a Bifrost riser or hit to replace it. From there, it's honestly just a matter of mixing, mastering, and boom. You got a finished MIDI production that sounds absolutely incredible. If you want your own Solemn Tones virtual instruments, you can go to solemntones.com and pick them up today. Enjoy. Ron.